dog. Talk for the people.
Trying to do personality. She doesn't. She's a dog. She doesn't have a personality. Well, she does have a personality. See, she just can't talk.
Bransfield.
A few times in videos of Bransfield's past, I've mentioned Mortal Kombat, a game I loved, a series I adored in my adolescence, something I played a lot of. When talking about it, chat inevitably veers towards the home conversions, and that chat then veers towards the qualities and differences in these conversions. Some looked better, some ran better, some were smoother, some were a joke. But the big point of discussion is always the violence. Was there claret, red viscous liquid, noggin explosions? Was there blood? Probably the most famous version for this line of chatter was that on the Mega Drive. That's Genesis to the minority who own the console with the wrong name. No, I don't care if the Genesis sold about 1.6 times as many units in North America than the Mega Drive did in the rest of the world combined. The SNES version of MK just didn't have blood and couldn't have it added in apart from by hacks or Action Replay or Game Genie codes. Other versions just didn't really matter as much as the big two on Sega and Nintendo's machines. So it all came down to the Mega Drive, and handily, the format was home to one of the most famous cheats in the history of all of games, the Blood Code. Loading up Mortal Kombat on Sega's console and jumping straight in, you were met with a diluted game, let's say. It played well, it looked alright, it was fun, but it was missing the splattering of gore everywhere, and the fatalities for some characters were, yeah. Sub-Zero goes from one of the most legendary finishing moves of all time to punching someone high. It wasn't quite the same, put it that way. But what you'd have noticed on loading up the game was the mention of a code of some kind, midway subtly pushing players in the direction that there must be something about the game, some kind of secret in there that would mix things up, that would allow you to sever some important arteries and show you in the 1993 version of graphic detail. It didn't take long for that very code to spread across playgrounds and workplaces the world over. ABACABB. On entering that string of inputs on the very screen hinting at a code and hearing Scorpion cry, "Get over here!" Weird, considering the undead ninja's fatality isn't one of the censored moves, you would unlock blood, and those fatalities that had been numbed to the point of ridiculousness would be restored to their over-the-top arcade gory glory. It was a brilliant cheat, it resonated with players, and it's still remembered incredibly fondly to this day, hence it being mentioned so much in comments where I've chatted about Mortal Kombat when I mentioned the Dullard code. The what code? Well, dear reader, let me let you in on a little secret that seems to be overlooked by a lot of folks, at least from my MK video experience. ABACABB isn't the best cheat code of all time, because it isn't even the best cheat code in Mega Drive Mortal Kombat. Instead of ABACABB on the code screen, get to the main menu and enter down up left left A right down, spelling dullard, and you will unlock a cheat menu. In the cheat menu, you can switch on blood, so just like ABACABB, but you're also introduced to a world of other cheats. Test your might selections, unlimited continues, knocking one player or the other's health down to danger levels, and a bunch of other stuff. It's essentially a debug menu, and it's far more robust and useful than the blood code alone is. As such, dullard is the only cheat code I bother to use when playing Mortal Kombat and Mega Drive. It's the only code I used back in the day, it's the one I've stuck with, and that's all because it is objectively the better cheat code. Now, obviously the blood code just does one thing, and does it quickly and easily, so it is easy to see why and how it permeated as it did, and why it's the code most people remember. Why it might have been the only code people ever bothered to pay attention to back in the day. You had a bloodless Mortal Kombat, you wanted blood, you could get it, and those peasant SNES owners couldn't do anything about it. ABACABB became shorthand for how cool the Mega Drive was, how edgy its games were, how arcade perfect its games could be. It wasn't just a code to turn on some red sprites and different finishing moves, it was a gateway to something illicit, and demonstrably better than that on the competing format. A victory in the console wars, and a mature little secret you could easily hide from your parents or any other pearl clutchers in the vicinity. It was the blood code being noticed after the game's release that, in part, saw the creation of the ESRB, the Entertainment Software Ratings Board, which still classifies games' age appropriateness to this day in the States. Something that just didn't exist, that didn't seem necessary before that cheat blew up on the scene. ABACABB was, in that respect, a cultural phenomenon, an important cheat as well as a fun one, a way of getting one over on the man, and something indelibly etched into the psyche of all those who played Mortal Kombat in the early 90s, even those who never even had a Mega Drive or Genesis. We all knew about it then, we all remember it now. I see its impact, I feel its importance, I recognize its place in gaming history as a whole. But the dullard code was more functional and so better? It was also a swipe at those attempting to push through censored video games to the public at large, at least that's how I see its use of the word dullard. It wasn't as snappy, it didn't have the immediate impact people wanted, you had to go through another menu and do some toggling. Ugh. But the functionality of the cheat was greater than that of the blood code, and while I definitely understand the relevance and importance of ABACABB, its place in gaming history, I will never stop pointing out, with my greatest internet contrarian voice, that actually, dullard was the best cheat code in Mortal Kombat on the Mega Drive. Thanks for attending my little Mortal Kombat cheat chat. Now, can you please stop trying to correct me about the blood code? I am right, you just didn't pay attention. Bye!